Today I'm going to show you how you can fix your car with a gun. But no, I'm not talking about using your 44 and putting an end to your car because you're sick of fixing it. I'm talking about using this, a temperature sensing gun to figure out what's wrong with your car. I've been using temperature sensing guns for decades to fix cars, but a long time ago, they cost over 900 bucks for a good one. But today, ones like this doctor meter, it only costs 29 bucks and it works really well. But that said, don't go too cheap. This Kingstop one was $14.99 on Amazon, and it didn't work as good. You're better off buying the $29 one. It's got a great colored readout, bold letters, and it even came with this quick draw holster. Now, the uses of these guns are pretty much only limited by your imagination. Maybe your car's overheating. You can check for hot spots using the gauge. Maybe you think your thermostat's sticking. Well, take the temperature before and after the thermostat. That way you don't have to take anything apart. It's a non-contact thermometer. Maybe your AC isn't running right. Well, you can check for a clogged condenser. Take temperature readings, and if some parts are hot and some are cold, you know it's clogged up inside. Maybe you think you have a bad catalytic converter. Well, you can take the temperatures of the front and take the temperature at the back. It should be much hotter at the back, and if it isn't, the cat's bad. Maybe your brakes are dragging somewhere. Well, you can stick the gun in little holes and you can take the temperature of the rotors. And if you find after a hard drive and you come back and take a temperature, one side much hotter than the other, you know the hot side is dragging. You can even use it to find electrical shorts. If you find that one wire is hotter than the other wire, you'll know that that wire has a short somewhere that's bringing too much power. Of course, you can use it to entertain your cat. They love chasing after the little dots. You can also use it to find misfiring engines by measuring the exhaust manifold temperature for each cylinder. The misfiring cylinders won't be burning all the gas, so they'll run cooler than the other ones, and you can figure that out. And just out of curiosity, how hot does it get in the back of a car in the sun? Over 183 degrees. No wonder I'd burn my hands when I pull it back in the driveway in the afternoon. So the next time your car breaks down, why not fix it with a gun? Well, not this gun. This temperature gun. And remember, if you've got any car questions, visit On the Road with Scotty.